Okay, no, no, okay, we're good. Okay, so you don't know. You don't know, so let me know.
Anyway,
but,
is phenomenal. All right, now we move back to the group of things. Okay, now y'all can be my first. Solos will be done by.
Yeah. these days. And we're going to unpack that a little bit more, a lot of it more, hopefully, and really start to think about self-care as wellness, as resilience, as self-worth. And we want to guide you all through a journey that hopefully will be self-reflective, but also then be a place to then reflect out into the world. Think about how you want to move forward in your own lives in 2018 and beyond.
Together today, we're going to go around the room and have folks say who they are, their names, how they want to be identified, and if that includes gender pronoun or other ways of identifying. And then answer this or respond to this prompt, wellness is, and fill in the blank. Phrase that introduces us to you and how you want to be referred to, and fill in the blank, wellness is. And we will go clockwise from the person who decides to start this introduction. And for the folks who are supporting behind the scenes, this includes you as well. We're all a community, so we would like to name how you want to be referred to and or gender pronoun. And wellness is fill in the blank. Who'd like to go first?
Hi, my name is Valerie Roshan. I'll deal with the pronoun thing. I'm Valerie Roshan. It's fine. Wellness is taking care of yourself spiritually, mentally, physically, communally. To me, that's, it's probably some others, but the rest of you will say them.
You know? The folks behind you, and then we'll come to you.
Okay.
And we'll continue around this way. Okay. All right. We can start with videographer.
Oh, yes.
Well, I can't videotape myself, unfortunately.
Right.
My name is Stoke. Today I want to be referred to as videographer. That sounds pretty cool. And can you repeat the last question?
Wellness is.
Wellness is ever flowing.
My name is Rare. I'm an artist, photographer, singer, Margot's child. And wellness is living in the.
Indira, good wine like you drink. And wellness is the ability to say no.
No, that's right.
Are she, her, hers, and to me, wellness is being whole.
Hi, I'm Lorraine Brown, known usually as Mama Brown. Wellness is contentment, peace, meditation, and sleeping good at night. Yes.
I'm Natasha Lee. My pronoun is she, and wellness is Christ.
Hi everyone, my name is Hannah. My preferred gender pronouns are she, hers, or they, them. Wellness to me is having the space to care for things that are important to you.
Ashley, she, her, hers. Wellness is
long, long baths in the middle of the day. And being okay with where you are, as you are, how you are.
And we're just going clockwise, so you would be next unless you are abstaining from participating.
Niambi Keys, choreographer, she. And wellness to me is survival.
Say that again.
Survival.
My name is Candace Thompson, she, her, hers, and wellness to me is being able to perceive what your needs are in a
Hi, I'm Tommy Flagg. We have a foundation and we're trying to bring the arts into central Pennsylvania, and we need to do that with ladies. And I thought this was a great opportunity to come and meet some wonderful ladies.
Do you have a gender pronoun or another way you would like to be referred to in the space?
Just me.
Okay. And wellness is what to you?
And wellness is the positive energy that we're trying to inject into our community. Mm-hmm.
All right. Back to the front. Yes.
My name is Cypher. BTF pronoun. And wellness is being content with who you are, regardless of who pronouns.
I'm Danny Terrell, my pronouns are my name. Wellness to me is to be studying about black queerness and know that I wrote in my name.
Hi, I'm Brady Ford, dancer and choreographer. He, she, they are all appropriate. And wellness is selfishness.
I'm
Mosley,
choreographer, singer, songwriter. She, her. Wellness is wearing all black and winter and making sure you shave well.
Hi, my name is Martha. I'm a volunteer with Dancing NYC. My pronouns are her, she, hers. And I have to echo others who said that wellness is contentment. You're content. That's quite an accomplishment. And I have to apologize to you, but I have to move a little early. And when I tell out, it's not because I don't want to be here.
Yes, please.
Oh, hello.
That's my niece.
What's your name? How do you want to be referred to, and what is wellness to you? How do you want us to identify you? Dig it.
Her afro. No.
You want to say something in this room full of all these old people? It's okay if you don't. Okay. It's a big question. I'm still trying to figure out the answer to it. So we're just going to move on.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for being here. Okay.
Mm-hmm. I'm Giselle Mason, dancer and choreographer. She, her, hers. Wellness is spiritual, physical, mental, and emotional wholeness.
I'm Jill Williams, director of Clark Center NYC. I think for me, wellness means trying to eliminate as much stress in life as possible.
My name is Kelly Thompson, she, her, hers. Wellness for me would be being willing to continually redefine yourself and to go on the healing journey over and over again in life.
Mm-hmm.
I'm Maria Daniels. She, her, hers. I'm going to have to agree with the good night's sleep.
My name is Remy Harris. She, her, hers. Wellness for me right now is taking care of myself before I take care of others.
My name is Brenda Dixon. I do everything I'm asked to do, like whether it's performing or writing or moderating or consulting or mentoring or and all of that somehow connected with the dance field. She, her. I'm just going to say it's a wellspring of wealth. I'll leave it at that.
I'm Tiffany. My pronouns are she, her, hers. I'm an art critic and filmmaker, and for me, wellness is warmth.
I'm Shalewa. I am a choreographer, performer, writer, and teacher. My pronouns are she, her, hers. Wellness is maintaining connection between my body and its processes and my community and my experience of the divine.
Hello, I'm Carol Marie Webster. I am a dancer, performer, activist, researcher. I prefer to be referred to as she, her, hers. And for me, wellness is active. It is all that I do to affirm, honor, and flourish in the best of who I can be in any given moment.
Hello, my name is Katrina Reed. Gender pronouns she, her. And wellness is a practice of listening to your intuition.
Kayla Hamilton, she, her, hers. Wellness is taking pauses throughout the day.
My name is Crystal Davis, she, her, hers. And wellness to me is about integration and balance of all the different balls in the air. Hi,
letting the imperfections of all of us shine through, let those to be our truest selves, so we can express our truest selves to others.
My name is Brittany, she, her, hers, and wellness is living my truth and making my own decisions and just giving as much love as I can without draining myself.
My name is Ebony Noelle Golden. Pronouns she, her, they. And wellness is living in my passion, living in joy, undeterred. And doing those things that I feel are most about my passion and my joy.
And wellness is being present. Wellness is tending to all of my needs. Wellness is saying no. Wellness is finishing my sleep.
Hi everybody, I'm Missy. Teaching artivist. And wellness, just touching and agreeing with what I was already gone forth in the space. Wellness is peace.
Hello, my name is Destiny D. Rock Young. Dancer and artistic director. And wellness to me is acceptance, forgiveness, evaluation, power, and healing of the mind, body.
Hey everyone, I'm Marcia, performing and teaching artivist. Identify as she, her. And wellness for me is just acknowledging, adjusting, and fulfilling.
Hello, my culture keeper and creator. And wellness to me is ritual practices and love of self and others.
Hi, I'm Vershawn Sanders Ward, and standing in my faith.
Hello, I'm Sai Olivia. I'm a program director, mother, and advocate, and she, her, and wellness is standing in your truth.
Hey y'all, hey.
Hey.
Nay, also Ravanessa, she, her, hers. Wellness is being aware of the flow.
Did we miss anyone? All right. So thank you all for already a toolkit and a buffet of practices of wellness and resilience that we can use. If you heard something that struck a chord with you, hopefully you make a note of that. And take that with you. During and strategy session, and it's the perfect time for it. We're living in a moment where, and not like unlike moments, previous moments to this moment, as individuals, as families, as communities, as artists, are kind of the medicine that we need to take us through and to reveal wholehearted and human. This moment culturally, politically, economically has some folks living on the edge of what may seem like breakdown, but what we are sitting preparation for this evening, but also in just in our collective work and in individual work, what does it mean to not just survive but to thrive? What does it mean to center yourself individually and your communities collectively to not just this generation but generations to come? And so this is also a celebration of what we know. To you know, what we know, what we've known for generations, what our families have known for generations, as it relates to thriving and getting beyond breakdown and survival. And there's a thing, you know, that we've been talking about, and I feel the encounters between the individual and the collective, and where wellness and that we begin to think about a bridge between the individual and the collective. And so what does it mean to have these kind of toolkits, a medicine bag, with the tools and strategies in them that have kept us here for generations? And what does it mean to build that? So we're here to talk about that. We're here to talk about how to sustain from that space. Important, you know, to know what's, for me, it has become increasingly important relationships to center family, because those are the things that I feel in my life are most under attack right now. And get in the way of all of the other things that I want to do. If there's no joy. So whenever there's an opportunity to be in a space to think deeply and I want to be there. So it really is an honor to be in this time and this moment with us, to share, to hear, to deepen, and to connect around resilience. Struggle and strife. I would like for us to just continue to think about how that vibration and that inward and what we want to project to our broader community as it relates to filling up that resilience and that wellness toolkit. Am I making sense?
Yes.
Yeah? Okay, all right. Set the what do you call that? The container. but this will pretty soon you will be, you know, doing some reflective work, group work to continue this conversation. I'm gonna say, all right now, write a 3-page manifesto on wellness. Go. All right. But maybe at the end.
In a comfortable place, which could stretch your legs and find another place in the room. Maybe you want to take a seat on the floor, but I want you to find yourself in a comfortable place. Ready, set, boom, go. Breathing in through the nose, filling up your bellies, and exhaling. Sometimes, if we're sitting up, having our feet flat on the floor, that helps us connect to that breath. Sometimes if we're on the floor, we can actually feel our bellies fill with air. And as you continue to take these deep breaths, we're just going to start to bring our attention to different parts of our body and just notice where we are right now. And we're just going to start from the bottom, start at the soles of our feet, and give some attention to our toes, our soles,
tops of the feet. Higher to the bottoms of our legs. Are we feeling some shin splints? Are our calves tight? You want to start to move or stretch if that feels right. Please give yourself permission to do so. If you want to just continue to breathe and give attention to that area of the body, that's fine as well. And then we're just going to bring some breath up the legs. Our hip flexor stretches like we like to. Just bring some breath and some ease there, letting go. And back of the body. Expanding your rib cage. The backs of the shoulders. Releasing in the shoulders. You might unintentionally be holding tension. Might even be all the way up by your ears and you don't even know, just let it go. Finding some space in the neck. And then starting to bring some attention to your face. Is your tongue doing weird things right now? Let it go. Releasing any tension in your face. If you feel it go, feel the difference. Relax your brows. And then bringing some attention to the top of your head. And thinking about the space above your crown. Bringing some energy down the arms, tops of the shoulders. Down your biceps, down your triceps, the back of the arm. Bring your attention rubbing. I see some folks rubbing their hands together, just giving some friction, some energy and just apply it to other places in your body. Mindful of your breath as you scan through your body. Present.
for yourself, I'd like for you to silently, I am worthy, I am worthy, I am worthy. You can feel it, that in for yourself. Wellness, I'm worthy of connection. Just for yourself, an internal affirmation of self-worth. Continuing to finding comfort in your sit or your on the floor. Imagining and visualizing with light, filling up your medicine and needs, expanding whatever needs to be expanded, whatever needs to be let go. What are you worthy of? We're going to transition into some walking in your worth. From a space, you walk with your worth. You walk in the full. Ask that your meditation, your walking meditation is done silently and together, and we may keep walking in our walk. But this should be done with your eyes open. One doesn't walk looking straight ahead. Be mindful. And you don't have to stay within the walk outside. Walk and stand and ponder your worth. Or you can walk the whole time. If you have things with you that someone may trip on, we ask that you just so folks feel comfortable. So A meditative walk. So when you're ready, with us, so that we can walking, and if you need to step out of it, back in. Paying attention to the way touch the floor. Attention to anything that might be in the way. Soft faces. Walking in your worth. Feeling the bottom. With your word. Take your pace down about 5% and see what comes up for you. That internal affirmation of worth going, I'm worthy of love, I'm worthy of life, I'm worthy of peace, I'm worthy of passion, I'm worthy of travel, I'm worthy of journey. Whatever, bringing that back to your presence. Connecting palm of floor to connecting palm of foot to the floor, mindful. Floor, toes touching the floor. Mindfully. In gratitude for this walk, this step, and your work. In gratitude of where you are on that journey of self-worth. If your mind starts to go, you feel yourself coming out of the meditation, breathe and come back into it, please.
walking in your worth, having a moment to be present in your body. We want to take this meditation to for achieving them, for sustaining them, for creating them. What are your recipes for resilience? We're going to take about 10 minutes. Thank you.
take a few more minutes. To the next activity, now is a good time before we transition. If you're done, we've spent some time being introspective, considering our work. And we have a little time built in to bridge between our introspective personal work and the work that we're about to do in group. So wanted to just ask writing, what happened during the walking meditation, visualization, what's going on? Yeah. What's present for you right now?
I think oftentimes, I think we all have done this at some point, but where I am personally is that I mentioned earlier that wellness is living in my truth. Practicing that for the last few years as far as my art and my career, not so much personally. So what came up for me is knowing that I'm worthy of support and consistency from people. Mm-hmm. of respect, but I have to start that with myself, because although I can say I'm doing one thing, I need to actually do it, or practice it. So that's what's coming up for me, is doing that across the board, because I'm kind of a fronter if I don't.
Anyone else?
For me, when we started,
I think it was the prompt was like 5%
slower. 5%
slower,
yep.
At first I was like, I don't know about that. Walking very slow felt like there's a conflict between like my worthy walk and a slow walk, and so what that came to in my writing was I'm worthy of leisure.
Worthy of leisure.
Worthy of leisure.
Connection between guilt and work. And so, I mean, yes, I'm not going to go deep into it, but I will just say I find in my own experience that there is a connection. And typically for me, guilt does nothing but, you know, like tax my immune system and just, you know, I break out and all kinds of crazy shit happens when I'm living and in guilt. It's bad for me. And so, like, dealing with guilt and shame and imposter syndrome. All right. I said I wasn't going to go. It's just, you know, it is, like, I keep using this word medicine, because medicine for me is not just pills you take, but when I'm able to unearth and get to my truth, then some of the other stuff, there's no pill that can cure guilt. Shame and all of the other things, imposter syndrome, jealousy, envy. And worth and wellness. For me, there is like a journey that I'm on that is not like just one destination forward, but it's like back, forward, side to side, like choreography. But trying to get to the wellness world, just trying to get there and just touch it. Now, more and more, that's been helpful for me. We have time for other folks. Thank you. Thank you for those who shared. Anyone else? What's coming up for you? Yes, please.
Oh. This month to take the entire month off, and I was terrified of that. But I'm doing it, and what I'm finding is I love it. Just to be able to do that, but I needed that.
resonate with other folks. Anyone else want to just co-sign or say a word or two about that?
We will not chase busy.
We will not glorify busy.
We will not chase busy.
I'm in a place where service has always been near and dear to my heart, my identity. Mm-hmm. And my job is in a place where they're like, no, you can't do that now. Mm-hmm. You have to take care of your passion and your interest.
Your job?
All the time. Mm-hmm.
All right.
Now, get along with that. It feels like they're taking something away from me. And I have to keep practicing to reframe. You don't have to be that busy. You don't have to do that. You can learn and explore something different. And if you decide it's not for you. Mm-hmm. So I'm trying to frame up stepping away from it as not being selfish and not losing my identity, but really living into, you remember that passion for research that you had back when you were in undergrad? Mm-hmm. Yeah, somebody's giving you an opportunity to do that. You can step into that, and that's been hard. Not to frame it up as, they don't want me to help my community. To let that go. So that busy.
Something that was on, that came up for me was letting my list sit. That I'm starting a new job, and I also have my own film that I'm working on, and there are always new things on the list. But knowing that they'll get done even if I don't do them right this second. I've been trying to practice that more.
Task list, to-do list, all
life
of the lists,
list,
life list. Okay, it can sit for a minute.
It could sit for a day or two, you know.
It will be fine.
Mm-hmm. Right next, but I want to hear from you and then yes.
But just to tag on to that, also not comparing my progress to others. Mm-hmm.
As I'm listening to everybody, I'm still looking at mine, what I have down as my worth. That is a comparison, but I'm thinking about what I wrote. It resonates through what I wrote, which is just as I am. I am worthy just as I am. Right now, I am not trying to become worthy. Being in my worthiness, not trying to become my worthiness.
Giselle, and
then
thank you.
Earlier you were talking about how all of these things come together. How they can enter. It actually even speaks to this. I can feel I'm getting sick like as we speak. And it's interesting like to walk and think of worthiness as I get sick. You know, because why didn't I do this? Why didn't I should have done that before? But still, wherever you are, like in that space, like I am worthy, right where I am, just as I am, and this is where I am right now. And like, just because things aren't at like 100, you know, like right, that I'm still worthy.
This whole thing about just as I am, I'm just like, you know, that present, trusting, Stokely, Giselle, Jill, passing by Maxine, feeling, making my worth.
Yeah. say one? I actually had a list. It speaks to what I don't. Several, I'll just mention a couple. To be better. Just as I am is. Just as I am is loving. Just as I am is forgiving. And I wrote several.
Some folks in my community have like love languages, which is a thing. It's a thing, like a book and a whole, which I feel like in my particularly, but not exclusively, one of the major. So you're not doing. Even when you are like your reserve is depleted, even when you do it with a your hand on your hip, but I love you, so I'm gonna do this even if it makes me, even if I don't want to do it. In my community, that is not helpful to any because, and it actually adds to feelings of worthlessness, feelings of worthlessness, and feelings of dis-ease, and feelings of being me or the people in my community. And so there's been some tweaking because at one point, I think I would have said my major love language was acts of service. I've seen, and what I've been saying recently is my great grandmother did enough acts of service, so I can don't have to do all of everything. And so I do think the love is self care and self worth in some parts of my community would be seen as obscene. This girl, it's Sunday night. It's something else to do. Circle thinking about how to be well. And so, you know, but it is. It's an act of resistance for the folks in my community to focus very deeply, like root and ground and go as deep as we can into thinking about being well and caring for ourselves.
Reclaiming our time.
Yeah. Reclaiming our time, reclaiming our rituals for wellness, reclaiming what has lived wholehearted lives today. Really important, really important. So we're going to now do some more work around these ideas.
Yes.
I feel like I've talked. Can I
make small circles? I think actually, like groups of maybe six, I think that feels right. If you can find yourself in small circles, that those circles, I will give you your next step. So we're moving, we're gonna put a little swiftness in our move in 5, 4, 3.
Come on.
blank note card around to you. I'm going to write, draw, describe in some way. What are you keeping or sustaining your resilience and your wellness? What are some barriers to that? What you need for a breakthrough so that you can sustain your resilience in your or barriers, the other side of your breakthroughs. What you need for your breakthroughs?
Breakthroughs and barriers. You can draw it, you can write it. Breakthroughs for this barrier, just make a note of them. They might be helpful. They may change your life in 1 minute. Okay? So yes.
Yes.
You share your barriers and your breakthroughs. You got 2 minutes, first person, eight, it's 8:18.
Yeah. and yeah. Nice.
Yeah.
Et cetera. So this is your moment to pull together all that has surfaced for you as a group. Creation. Here you go.
We have about 7 minutes.
Yes, that's for the big paper.
wellness manifestos and however you want. So whatever you need to do to get ready, take 1 minute and then you can stay where you are. We don't have to come back into the circle. Figure out what you're going to do, and in about a minute, we're going to start. Okay? Thank you.
Traditions that fulfill us, and we will embrace the
schedule. remembering who we are, honoring ourselves by prioritizing. Developing and renewing our sense of fearlessness.
Allowing time and space.
Since we're at registration, we didn't get to write it on the big board. Yes. Somebody said adapt
Our wellness honors our professional and our wellness looks like sleep. Giving purpose to our wealth.
Practice kindness to others. Everyone has social media is not the truth. Okay, distractions.
are things that I have been personally reflecting on, but I think that this space is, these questions are right in this space. What does it feel like? What does it feel like to be fully supported? When was the last time you did something for the first time? That you took 2 hours to be self-reflective, introspective, and in the space of self-healing. Practice and your own practices that you generated and that you've exchanged with each other, and to keep moving forward with them. We can heal ourselves. We have a lot at our disposal. That our mothers have taught us, and our aunties and our grandmothers. And I invite you all to keep moving forward in your own.
Thank you.
We appreciate you all for spending time.